If you have something that you are passionate about and you think that you could make a living at it or at least make some money doing it, but you kind of realize you got to do it for free at first, is it worth it? Should you be working for free? Well, I've got some insights about that. Welcome to Working Mom Warrior. I'm Moca Mom, and I'm going to give you some tips and ups and downs about my life in my vlog, because my channel is all about helping working moms relate to the working moms that I interview who are from all different backgrounds and share their successes and failures so you can feel better about the job you're doing as a mother and a professional. Many of us are trying to do everything perfectly, and when we find out that everyone who looks like they have it all together doesn't really, we feel a little bit better about ourselves. And that's my goal, is to give you some inspiration. And I want to talk to you today about doing something that you will feel really passionate about, and if you should spend time doing it, if you have to do it for free. And the reason I'm talking about this is because I have some big news. I just got offered my first paid speaking gig. Yes, I've been speaking for free for well over a year. I've probably done about 8 or 10 or 12 speeches, and someone contacted me and offered me, yay, $500, and I said yes, and I've got some time to prepare and to really do well with this one and take it from there. Now, my whole goal is not to be a paid speaker. That's part of the overall goal of creating Working Mom Warrior, which is a community of girlfriends who can share ideas that I spend time interviewing all over to get all different ideas about the things that work for you and don't work for you to help each other. My real passion is in doing interviews and producing videos, and that's what I'm doing with my YouTube channel. But in order to grow that and to spread the message and to brand myself, I've been doing free speeches because it's part of the overall business plan. So, should I have been spending my time doing these speeches? Well, I will tell you, first of all, I didn't put a lot of effort into doing these speeches in the beginning. I put up a profile. I wasn't sure what was going to happen. I came up with an idea, and then I waited to see if anyone contacted me. And people did. It was on a site that people could go to find free speakers, and so somebody contacted me and said that they were interested in having me come out to their group. It was a small group, maybe 15 people, but I took it very seriously. Now, I spent 15 years as a television reporter, talking with a microphone to an audience, but through a camera, not in front of a crowd. I've done that a few times, but not a speech where I am basically the keynote speaker, even for a small group. So I wanted to spend time preparing this, taking my concept and really fleshing it out. So I spent at least 20, if not 30, 40 hours really honing this, rewriting it, revising it, practicing it, making sure I knew this without having to depend on notes and bringing some props and really putting together something that I thought would be entertaining and informational and inspirational to the audience. And it was a lot of fun and I enjoyed it. And so as time went on, every month or two, someone would contact me and ask me if I could go out and give a speech to their group. And I almost always said yes. There were times that it didn't work out. The person who hired me left the company and various things would happen. We had to revise our, you know, schedule and we don't need a speaker now. But I would plan for it and I would put in the time. Each time I did it, I actually would spend another 10, 15, 20 hours revising, making the speech better. One time, the person who contacted me was from a human resources department, and she said, we put together these speakers for our employees to watch when they have their lunch break. They eat lunch and then they go attend this speech if they want to. It's optional. But she said it's going to be like 20, 30 people, which was a, it ended up that more people than that signed up. I think they had like 60. So they wanted me to do the same speech twice. And I said, I'd be happy to do that right in a row, especially because I didn't have to go there two different times. But she did say, we like to have an interactive element. You have something interactive. And I didn't really. I'd used a few props. I'd created a PowerPoint. But I said, I will come up with something. And I did. And I'm really glad she made that suggestion. This is another thing that happens when you do something for free, is you really hone your craft and then you get feedback from other people and that helps you make it better. So ever since then, I've had this interactive element that I've revised and made better, and I really feel it pulls the people in the audience into what I'm explaining, which is about coming up with the idea of goals. What is it in your life? Not necessarily that you want to achieve, but maybe that you're neglecting and maybe even in denial about. How do you recognize that? How do you figure out what it is that you need to do to fix it? And then how do you implement that plan to fix it? So that's what my speech encompasses. And when I when I do this interactive situation with them where I give them a handout and have them fill out certain things, it really brings them more into it. And I think it's more effective in helping them in their life, which is the whole point of this. You want to make sure that if you're working for free, you're doing something you enjoy. Not, oh, I'm going to do this in this podunk place and I'm going to talk about something stupid they want me to talk about, but I don't really care because someday I'll get to do it in a way that I want and that's what I'll enjoy, but I don't now. Mm-mm. It has to be enjoying the process now if you're going to do it for free. That's my opinion. Now, there are plenty of things people do for free for hobbies. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about something you're doing for free that you plan to eventually get paid for or want to get paid for or even want to make a living at. If you're doing that, then you want to be able to enjoy what you're doing now for free because things don't always work out the way you plan. And I have put a lot of time and effort into things that I thought would pay me and they didn't. They didn't turn out the way I thought. So if all of that time and effort in doing something for free was to get paid and it didn't come to fruition, then I really wasted a lot of time. You don't want to feel that you're wasting your time. You want to feel that you're enjoying what you're doing. I have driven to another state hours away to give a speech. No, I wouldn't do that every week. I don't have the time to do that every week for free. I'm not independently wealthy. But I'm doing it because I enjoy what I'm doing. It's part of my overall plan, and I'm willing to do it once in a while for free because I know that I'm enjoying the experience of what I'm doing. I'm contributing something, and I have an ultimate goal, which is that as this continues to build my brand, it's going to help me monetize the brand, and eventually I will get paid to speak. If I do more and more of these speeches, the idea is eventually I'm not going to always be doing them for free. So that's the next step, is make sure if you're doing this to earn money at it, and you're initially doing it for free for a while, that you have a plan to eventually get paid. Whether it's putting your information on a site where you could get paid, or starting to market yourself in a different way, or putting together a reel that tells people about you. I mean, there are a lot of musicians and actors that hone their craft for free and even take classes and pay to learn about their craft. But maybe eventually they've got a plan. Well, I'll get in some community theater. Well, I'll get a small stipend and then I'll move up from there and I'll keep trying to get an agent and they can get me some paid work. Even if it's not the most enjoyable, maybe I'll do commercials even though I eventually want to act in television. So there are always going to be some things about it that you don't enjoy. I mean, we love our children, but we don't like everything they do. Same with your spouse or anyone else in your life or even a job that you love. You don't necessarily like every aspect of it, but you should be loving what you're doing overall, feel a passion for it as you're doing it now with a plan to do it in the future and eventually get paid for it and follow the steps of the plan. So that's my tip about doing something for free, whether or not it's worth it, and how to make it eventually become something you get paid for. It's just an overall goal. I'm not giving you real specifics. There's a lot out there about that, but I hope you're inspired by it and you subscribe to Working Mom Warrior and you click on the next video to get more tips and inspiration about balancing career and kids, because I want to be that tribe of girlfriends along with all of the women that I interview, so you are committed to living your best life and doing the best that you can with what you have and not getting down on yourself. So I look forward to seeing you in the next video, and I look forward to meeting you and hearing more about you in the comments.